What is up, YouTube? Welcome to Panfro Games, and in today's video, we have a brand new easy shiny hunting exploit method in a cave that's very similar to the Sandshrew cave that we covered earlier in the channel, and we're going to be hunting a great Pokemon. We're going to be hunting Cleffa, and we can hunt another Pokemon in as well. And of course, guys, if you like this type of content, enjoy these types of videos. Please leave a like, subscribe if you're new. I really appreciate it. Consider supporting the channel by joining the Pan Fam by hitting that join channel member button below. So let's begin with the location of this exploit cave. And we're going to be starting off at the Kitakami Hall area, just right outside on the steps here. So everyone can easily follow this. So from here, we are actually going up to this green patch on the map right here. Now, to get to the cave from Kitakami Hall is pretty simple. We're just gonna get on our ride Pokemon and just jump right on over there. Now, just make sure you don't run into any random Pokemon on the side here because they can be annoying. Now, you're gonna see a cave right in front of you right here. This is not the cave we're going into, so definitely ignore that. The cave we're going to it is to the right over there. But first, we're gonna make a pit stop at this tree. Now, you can't actually make a picnic in that location in that cave, and there's the cave right in front of us, and nor can you make a picnic outside of the cave. So how do we actually reset? Well, we're gonna do a proximity reset. What we're gonna do here is one, save our game like always, just in case anything bad happens, you know, just the usual. Then we're gonna set up our picnic. If it says you can't make a picnic, well, you're probably not like right in the center. I'm not even too in the center, but I'm still able to make a picnic. And now from here, we're gonna go for the fairy type hunt or Cleffa. And we're going to be using one tomato, one salty, and one spicy. Recipe is in the top right-hand corner of the screen if you need that guidance. Now, you're going to be getting about 10 Cleffas and 5 Clefairies in this spot. It's the exact opposite of the previous spot recorded where, you know, it would about... I would say maybe not exact opposite. I would say you get like 50-50 on Cleffa, Clefairy. But, you know, if you got the Clefairy cluster spawns and you only got one Cleffa, so you're like really relying on like the individual Cleffas to spawn in. Here, it's a lot easier to actually isolate for the Cleffa. I would recommend this if you just wanted to get the Cleffa. If you really want to get the Clefairy, check out my previous video because that's going to be incredibly helpful for you too. Now that we have our level 3 fairy sandwich with Sparkling Tidal and Counter Power level 3, we're ready to begin this hunt. Now that we have our sandwich, let's head on over to the cave. We're going to glide over and climb up the hill here. And this cave is going to start populating with Cleffas and Clefairies. Now, we want to go to one of the corners, probably the corner where you don't get like a random spawn attacking you. And you can see that we're getting a lot. You actually get a full 15. The cave fills up. The only annoying part about this is like sometimes they'll block your exit here, which is pretty funny. But yeah, the shinies for Clefairy and Cleffa are very easy to notice. They got like green tipped ears. They can pay attention. So there's one way to reset this one. You could either glide back to where we just were and then glide all the way back into the cave. I mean, it's a little bit slower, but it does guarantee work. You don't really need to think about it otherwise. It does guarantee. And you know you did the reset correctly when the cave, it doesn't have the full 15 Pokemon again. The fact that it only had like 2 or 3 when we just walked in mean pretty much all the spawns did reset. And once again, we're just gonna chill here and wait for the spawns to come in, get our 15. Once I feel confident, okay, we're probably not gonna get the shiny on this one. That's a-okay. Just get on our ride Pokemon, leave the exit. Now, if you wanna do another reset, you have another option. Your other option is you could just like go down here and then climb up. Now, I don't know the exact amount of like time you need to go down there. This is definitely faster. But it did reset everything. So I don't know the exact depth you need to go to reset the cave, but that's another good way to do it as well if you are interested in doing that one. Pretty much just going down the wall and then climbing back up is going to be the fastest. Now, we're going to show off an AFK hunting method for us because it honestly seems like it could work really well. And, you know, if some people want to try it, I would recommend it. So we're going to run into the cave, dodge the Pokemon, and run to the right side. Run to the right side. We want to make the right side our side. It seems like the other side has much better spawns in general. Now, there's a little bit RNG on what the spawns are, where they are, but you want to send out your auto battle Pokemon. And our Gallade here, it should be knocking out every single one of these guys. And because the cave is pretty small, he should be able to take out pretty much all of these Cleffas and Clefables. You may want to set them up at first because, you know, okay, he had no one to run up to. So we cleared out this side. So throw him out again. Have him clear out over there. And once he gets, you know, the stragglers out of the way, you can see where all the spawns are coming in over there. So as long as he can keep them all contained in the corner, he can do a true AFK. So we're going to throw out the Gallade onto the Cleffa. And because we're far away, they're not actually coming towards us for the most part. They may like waddle around like that one over there. But there we go. Now we got Gallade right on top of the spawn of a bunch of other Pokemon. And you can sort of sit here and just wait for the shiny to appear. Now, auto battle Pokemon will not knock out a shiny Pokemon, which is incredibly helpful and really useful. So I do recommend this if you're like doing something else, playing another game on the side, watching a movie or something and want to pay attention. And for the most part, this should work. Of course, it's not 100% foolproof because the AI can be absolutely garbage, just like there. Gallade just stopped suddenly attacking for no reason. But if that does happen, just throw out your Pokemon again, clear out the guys on your side. And then if he's too far away from the others, then just have him be thrown out again. But honestly, this is a relatively chill hunt if you want to passively hunt it. So I think it's a pretty cool option if you want to try it this way. Well, I went outside for about 10 minutes doing the AFK attempt, and we did get a shiny Clefairy. Not the Cleffa I was hoping for, but hey, shiny the shiny, and it didn't work too hard for it, so I'll take that. That's a big dub. And for our next hunt, I'm going to be going for a flying type sandwich, or you can use a normal type sandwich. Both would actually work here. But I'm going to go with the Prosciutto and one salty and one spicy. And we got Sparkling, Tidal, and Counter Level 3 for flying type Pokemon, and ready to begin this hunt. So the exact same thing with Clefairy and Cleffa. I'm going to go into the cave, and we're going to be getting 15 Hoothoot spawns. Sometimes you get a Noctowl in here to appear, but it's really mostly going to be Hoothoots. The shiny for Hoothoot is super obvious, and it seems to like cluster a bit, which is pretty interesting. So you can do the reset method as we showed off, where you just like jump back here or jump to the side, come back, and hopefully you get the shiny for the Hoothoot. Or you could just try to stay into one corner, like this corner over here, throw out your battling Pokemon, and you can just hang out here and watch the Hoothoots fill up this place if you would like to do that. It's weird how the Hoothoots do somehow spawn in a little bit of a different place than necessarily the Cleffas and Clefairies did. And because they are cluster spawns, this is actually much more consistent on like an AFK hunt method on the Hoothoot. So if you want to do an AFK Hoothoot, this is going to be a great way to do it because, yeah, they just cluster in. They do fly, which can be a little bit problematic, but they'll also fly down. And the fact that they spawn with so many at once is pretty good. Of course, you want to make sure your auto battle Pokemon is all the way over in the other corner so you can best do this method. But yeah, there you go, guys. That is the two different Pokemon that you can hunt in this area. Well, technically three with the Cleffa and Clefairy and one sandwich. So good luck to you guys on this shiny hunt. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any other good shiny hunting methods. I really appreciate it. And happy shiny hunting, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out.